Good day. Today we are going to discuss about the student support services in Indira Gandhi National Open University. Student support services, they constitute an integral component of the academic support provided to the learners. Being an ODL system, there are various queries in the minds of the new learners, those who seek admission to different programs of study at Indira Gandhi National Open University. And obviously, what exactly they expect from the institution and what way they would be able to carry out their studies and what are the ways of evaluation. These are all some of the aspects which get covered in the student support services. So this we will be discussing in next few slides. Basically, these student support services, they try to facilitate the learners to make appropriate choices and decision by providing right guidance and counseling as to what exactly is the course which suits their requirement, what way they'll be able to fulfill in terms of their eligibility criteria, and of course, how much time they will be devoting in doing it. Then it enables the learners to effectively utilize the study material provided by the institution. Study material ODL system is a different kind of a material which we normally call as the self-instructional learning material, and there what way one has to use, this is what we try to convey to the learners. And finally, it also provides an opportunity for human interaction to reduce the sense of isolation amongst the learners, because there are no regular classes, and once they are left to fend for themselves, obviously they would like to have human interaction in terms of the teaching support and in terms of the support which is required for them for carrying out their studies. Now, what are the areas of learner support? Basically, the students, they look for areas such as information support, that what are the different programs of study of the institution, what are the admission requirements, what is the fee structure, what way the study material would be provided to them, what is the system of assessment and evaluation, etc. Then next is the institutional support. Who are the academic counselors, where the academic counseling would be held, provisions of assignments, practicals, how would the practical based programs like BCA, MCA or sciences, what way the practicals would be conducted. Then what way the electronic media is being utilized, because IGNU is one of the institution where massive use of the electronic media is being undertaken to ensure that the proper teaching learning takes place for the students. Then what are the learning centers where the students will have access to the counselors, what are the library facilities available to them, then how they are going to submit their assignments, how will it be evaluated, when their term and examinations would be held, and other related support. And finally, feedback about the assignment responses and the other study tasks to facilitate the process of study and reduce the sense of isolation of the learners. Now, there are different components of the support services. These components are, they are basically pre-admission counseling and general information. Pre-admission counseling, basically, we provide the information pertaining to the different programs of study which are on offer as per the requirement of the learners. Then what eligibility conditions they have to fulfill, what are the other considerations they have to take into account, they all get covered in the pre-admission counseling. After once proper information has been provided, then comes the next component of admission and re-registration. Once a student has decided, then he or she goes for admission. Everything is being done online. So one has to take admission. And once you are registered, except for the certificate and diploma program, which are only of fixed duration in terms of 6 months or 1 year program, for the bachelor's and master's degree to graduate to the next level, either next semester or next year, one has to do re-registration. So re-registration is essentially required for that. And when is it to be done? What are the time schedules, etc., etc.? All these things are detailed over there. After when the admission is confirmed, then an important aspect which comes into play is the distribution of the study material. When the student is likely to receive the study material, how they will be receiving the study material, this is an important aspect and they have to look into it. Normally, for a regional center like Delhi 3, we provide the study material immediately after the confirmation of the admission of the learner. After that, the allocation of the student takes place at the study center. Now, allocation of student at the study center implies that there are various institutions such as colleges affiliated to different universities like Delhi University, IP University, MDU University in Haryana, where the study centers are located. These are basically institutions where already conventional teaching goes on. So they are attached and actual so-called teaching takes place in terms of the counseling and tutoring support at the study center. Once they are allocated there, immediately thereafter, induction program is held, wherein they are informed about the counseling schedule and tutoring support. And after that, they continue their studies. As a part of the overall program curriculum, assignment is an important aspect. So there the students are told and informed that they have to compulsorily submit an assignment which constitute about 25% to 30% of the total assessment weightage. And there they have to understand that there are fixed deadlines within which the assignments are to be submitted at the designated study center. Once they are submitted, they are evaluated there. And after evaluation, the grades are transmitted to the regional center where processing takes place and subsequently it gets uploaded on the main website of the university. Then comes the role of electronic media or what we call as the teleconferencing support. At IGNU, you know, electronic media plays a very important role in terms of providing support, which we call as supplementing and complementing the face-to-face teaching that takes place in the form of the academic counseling. It is through the television, it is through the radio, it is through the web-based support. So all these are the so-called electronic media support which we provide to the learners for providing academic support to them. And finally, once you are done with a particular semester or year, then the examination is conducted, the term and examination. And during the examination, where the examination center will be, all the details are given in advance at the time when the students, they submit their online examination form. They take the examination at the designated examination center. After the examination, results are declared, whatever other requirements of the particular program is, whether in terms of the submission of the project or submission of the dissertation or fieldwork, all those things are taken care of. And then finally, the results are declared. Thank you.